368 pips was the total amount of pips that we were able to deliver to our clients in the premium group of Telegram. As we can see, my friends, the kickoff of Monday was not so good, but however, it was still a very small loss of 22 pips. Yet another one, of course, of 25 pips. But however, that in the end of the day, actually, we have sent the results by end of the day. As we can see, it was full of green. And thankfully, almost all of the signals which we have sent on Monday and also some of the open signals pending since the last week, as you can see, for example, the pound CHF pending since 15 of July has actually made 100 pips of profit. And as you can see, these are the total results on Monday and a few days also from the last week. Then Tuesday, as you can see, was also a good day, and thankfully it was a very good day with some profits. But sadly, of course, AUDGPY has hit the stop loss of 35 pips. So I think it's still a very good week so far, and we have made very good and decent pips. But again, I'm telling you, this is actually the total amount of pips. Some members have made less, some members have made more. It's of course depend on each client and how they have handled these signals. In the end, Extreme Trader is just sending you signals. We are never managing any funds. We are not promising amount of profits. We are just promising you the good quality of Extreme Trader signals, and hopefully it's going to be profitable. So of course, if you wish to join Extreme Trader Forex Signals Group, please contact our support. You can find their contact details in the description below this video. Contact them today and hopefully we will see you there. And now it's time to check these signals which I have sent here last Saturday, and thankfully almost all of them have went in the right direction, as we can see. But sadly, not all of them have triggered the sell or buy, except of course for the USDCHF, which has already triggered the sell order, and as you can see, it has been activated and it went all the way straight to the take profit level, making more than 111 pips of profit. The gold hasn't been triggered yet. USDGPY sadly now it's running in the profit. As we can see, it was actually ranging in the safe zone, currently running in about 31 pips of profit. So I think it's a very good result so far, and of course not a single comment says anything about that. Of course, when everything is going well, not a good, of course, I don't want to be sound like a baby here. Of course, I really appreciate the nice comments I'm receiving. It's very supportive and very friendly. However, yet I'm still looking for the comments says that we have made profit from this signal. Thankfully, I think one of them have said that he have made a profit from the gold, which was actually very overwhelming for me. But still, I want to see some more comments about these signals. For example, did anyone make any profit from the USDCHF? I really want to know. I want to know if you guys have taken any profits from this signal, and share with everyone your experience with these signals here on YouTube. Anyway, enough talking about me, and let's now talk about the signals, and let's begin, of course, with the Euro USD. So, of course, we are still going to maintain a buy order for the Euro USD. As you can see right here, I need to get rid of the old signal, and let's now check together what we can do next with this pair. Now, we have right here a structure. As you can see, the gold has indeed managed to break out from that structure. Pay attention to something here. I wanted to say this. We have right here a real level of the resistance, and we have right here two attempts which we can call a false breakout. Yet the real level of the resistance lies exactly right here and right there. And as you can see, the real level of the resistance has been respected later, which means we cannot really include the false breakout in the structure, which means that most likely the Euro USD is actually going to continue the fall, and it's going to retest the broken resistance right here from this structure, and most likely that previous resistance is going to become a new support. Of course, that's all being analyzed on the 1 hour time frame. We cannot do that. We have to go to the daily charts. Of course, I'm not going to the weekly, since actually I'm analyzing now the midweek analysis. So the weekly candle is still live. However, now as you can see right here on the daily chart, we had right here the real level of the resistance at 1.01895. And as you can see, this candle is actually going to expire after just 2 hours and 49 minutes. And most likely, it's going to be a bullish one, which means we can consider now buying the Euro USD. Which means we need now to go to the smaller time frame to identify where exactly we can start buying the Euro USD. I prefer to go to the 1 hour time frame, since actually you can see more details and more tails and wicks on the patterns. So right now what I'm going to do is simply draw right here a support trend line and drag it all the way to that resistance trend line. Just like that. So as we can see, we had here the support trend line, which has been respected again as a resistance trend line. And of course, my friends, again, we are having right here a real level of a resistance trend line, a false breakout, and another real resistance or resistance trend line. However, now we can expect from the EURUSD to fall all the way, respecting the same level of the support trend line and keep that position. And most likely we can start buying the EURUSD right here exactly. However, we need to check also the real level of the resistance as well. So as we can see, here exactly lies the real level of the resistance at 1.01913, which means we have to wait for the EURUSD to fall for about 40 pips, I would say, before we can start buying it. And I think this is going to happen soon. The bearish movement now is strong. The pullback is strong. And just by the way, by the time I'm talking, the market has fallen for about 3 pips. Currently now 37 pips far away from the entry. And as we can see, this level was previously a resistance. And right here as well, we had a false breakout. And again, we had the real level of the resistance. It all actually depends on that support trend line, and hopefully it's going to be respected. So anyway, if we started buying the EURUSD right from that point, where exactly we can start shorting? Or sorry, I mean the target. Why did I say shorting? The target, my friends, it has to be right here at the nearest strong key support level at 1.03580. Most likely the EURUSD is actually going to continue the rise till it reaches that level of a previous support. Meanwhile, the safe zone is going to be ranging just till the lowest level of the support at 1.01278, which means we are actually aiming approximately 165 pips more from buying the EURUSD, and the safe zone is going to be ranging for about 62 pips. Let me now write the signal for you. And there goes your signal, my friends, for the EURUSD. Again, I have to remind everyone to hold your positions till you see a clear price action indicates that we can indeed buying the pair right here. Don't ever buy the EURUSD if you have witnessed here a very strong bearish breakout candle. Don't do that. Don't set any pending orders at all. Make sure that you are waiting for the price action to confirm our entry. In the end, I'm not predicting how the market will move. I'm just analyzing it, and I'm sending you my expectation for how it can move. Actually, I'm not telling you that it's definitely gonna reverse from that point. So please don't set any pending orders. Make sure you are waiting for the right price action. So anyway, that's everything for the EURUSD. Let's now check the next pair, and let's move to the pound USD. By the way, actually, I think I made a mistake right here, because I think, okay, they are switched. Yeah, because I have this. Okay, this is actually a mistake here. I have done this mistake. Okay, so this is my chart which I am trading on, and this is the one for the analysis. And please don't send me these notifications while I'm recording. Anyway, let's now begin the pound USD. So of course I need to delete the old signal, and let's now check what we can do with the pound USD. Actually, if we check the daily chart right now, the daily chart shows us that the pound USD has actually made the strong breakout from the resistance level right here at 1.19728. If I go back to the 4-hour time frame, we can see clearly that the market has made here a strong bullish breakout candle from that long-term resistance. And again, we can check right here that the same level, almost the same level, was previously a strong key support level. And as you can see, the pound USD seems like it's approaching the setup. It's just about 15 pips far away from that entry. But however, I don't really feel safe to buy the pound USD from that level. That's why what I believe is the pound USD has actually reversed from that long-term resistance at 1.20347. We can see clearly that the pound USD has made here several attempts to break out from that resistance. And again, we can see one more and another attempt to break out from that level of the resistance. So buying the pound USD right now is not the best idea. We have to wait a better level to start buying the pair. Let's now move to the daily chart. So on the daily chart, actually what I'm seeing right here is a very strong key support level exactly right here. My aiming is for this support level right here on the daily chart. Now, after identifying this level on the daily chart, let's go back to the 4-hour time frame. Better. Now we can see it clearly on the 4-hour time frame, and we can identify that this was indeed a very good level to start buying the pound USD, and that has already happened today. However, the market after failing to break out from that level of the resistance, it seems like it's actually going to continue the fall till it reaches again the same level of a strong key support level at 1.19347, which means we will have to wait for the pound USD to fall for another 51 pips before we can start proceeding to buying it. And of course, if we check the support trend line, we can see clearly that the market here has created a support trend line, and we can expect from the pound USD to fall again to that level, respecting the support trend line and also respecting the strong key support level. Pay attention also that later on, the same level of a strong key support level has been respected right here, which means this was right here a false breakout. So as we can see, that support has been respected actually several times right here and right there as well, and we can expect to buy the pound USD again from the same level. And I believe if that happens, the pound USD is actually gonna make a strong breakout. Let me just show you. We are having right here also a resistance trend line, just like that. And as you can see, the market has indeed made the bullish breakout from that resistance trend line, which means the market is gonna continue the fall. First of all, it's gonna be respecting the real level of the support. And second of all, that broken resistance trend line is going to become a new support trend line, which means we can expect from the pound USD to continue the rise till it reaches the highest level of the resistance at 1.22020, which means we can expect to make 273 pips profit from this signal. Of course, that is so unrealistic signal. That's why I'm going to give you the target right here at the peak of the real resistance at 1.212331. Which means we are aiming 185 pips profit from this signal. Meanwhile, the safe zone is going to be ranging just a little bit right here till the lowest level of the real support at 1.18641, which means the safe zone is ranging for about 71 pips and the target is about 186 pips. Let me now write the signal for you. And there goes your signal, my friends, for the pound USD. Let's now move to the next pair. And let's begin with the AUD USD. Alright, so of course I have to delete the old signal since it's no longer valid. I receive a call here, which I really don't want to answer right now. However, I want to tell you something. The previous take profit level that we have selected for the AUD USD is gonna be our new entry. For a very simple reason. That level, as we can see, we had right here a very strong key support level as 0.68538. That actually has become a strong resistance level. But keep in mind that the market has actually shown here a very strong reversal very powerful reversals happened every single time the market has reached this level of a support. But when it became a resistance, the market has barely made any movement at all. And as we can see, even the second attempt of the resistance has barely made any pips, and the market has instantly made a very strong bullish breakout from that level of a resistance. Now, definitely, the market is going to continue the fall, and that previous level of a strong key support level is definitely going to be respected, in my opinion. So, I think if I want to rate this signal, I would rate it 5 stars. Because I think it's very trusted, in my opinion, and I think we have to wait for the pair to fall for about 44 pips before we can proceed to buying it. And don't forget that we also have right here a very strong structure, which has been recently breaking out from. So most likely the AUDUSD is gonna be respecting that level. Again, I don't really want to use the words definitely, for sure, definitive, 100%. This is really bad. I should really call it off. I would say most likely, perhaps I strongly believe that the AUDUSD is gonna reverse right from that level. However, if that happens, it's gonna be a very good signal. Because right here, as you can see, we have the broken resistance trend line. We can expect from the AUDUSD to be ranging inside this level for a while before finally start the bullish reversal and to start flying after reversing from that level. However, the target has to be placed right here at 0.69881, which means we can expect to make about 131 pips profit from this signal. Meanwhile, the safe zone is going to be ranging just till, as we can see right here, my friends, we had right here the support zone, So that's gonna be actually our safe zone as well. So let me just make sure. Yes, exactly, just like that. Exactly, just like that. That's gonna be our safe zone, just like this. And let me just write the signal for you right now, since it's almost there, by 0.68538. And the take profit level is gonna be placed at the strongest resistance level at 0.69881. Why did I say this is the strongest level of the resistance? Because as we can see, the market has made right here a false breakout from that level of a resistance and had right here the real level of the resistance, which was previously a strong key support level. So most likely, this is actually the strongest level of the real resistance that we have in the structure so far right here. So the AUDUSD most likely is going toward that level of the real resistance. So that's everything for the AUDUSD. Let's now move to the next pair. Let's now take a look at the USD CAD. All right, so let me now delete the old signal. The USD CAD has indeed went in the right direction, but of course did not trigger our sell level. Now, the first thing that we can notice right here on the USD CAD is the trend lines. Now we can see clearly that the pair has actually here made a very strong key support trend line, and the market has made the final bearish breakout from that level of a support trend line. Now let's pay attention to that level right here. This is very interesting, because right here we are having, my friends, the real level of the resistance lies exactly right there at 1.29245. Now let's pay attention to the details. That level has previously been a support right here and right there. Meanwhile, this was a false breakout. Then we had right here a false breakout, and then we had here the real level of the resistance. Now we can see that the market has finally become a support right here, but I don't know why it didn't reach the same level. But however, we can see that the market has made here a massive breakout from that level on the 4-hour candles. Now, this candle is gonna expire within just 2 hours and 33 minutes. We have to wait for the USD CAD to rise for about 33 pips. First of all, the real level of the resistance is gonna be respected. Second of all, the broken resistance trend line, support trend line, sorry, is gonna be retested and most likely is gonna pass. And I think the USD CAD is gonna continue the fall at least to reach the strongest key support level right there at 2.725, which means that's going to be our target right there, which means we're actually expecting to make 151 pips profit from this signal. Meanwhile, the safe zone should be ranging just till the peak of the resistance at 1.29890, because if the market is going to be able to reach that level, it means that this support trend line hasn't been broken out from, and all what we had right here was simply a false breakout, and the USD CAD might continue the rise. But we have to wait and see what will gonna happen. That's why I'm telling you, never ever set any pending orders. Always make sure that you are waiting for the actual price action to occur and to confirm your entry before you proceed to sell or to buy. Sadly, some members here, they are actually just sending pending orders. And not only that, but the edge of the safe zone is their stop loss. And this is pissing me off, actually, because this is totally wrong. The edge of the safe zone is never a stop loss, my friends. It's just a safe zone. It's called a safe zone for a reason. So what if the market will hit the edge of the safe zone? You will tell me it hit the stop loss, but that's a safe zone. It's a safe zone. How can you tell me it hit the stop loss? No. We call it a loss only if the market has made a strong bullish breakout from the safe zone. If the market has indeed exited the safe zone, then we call this with a loss. But touching the edge of the safe zone, then telling me it hit the stop loss, then just unsubscribe and just unfollow. I mean, really, this is just pisses me off. Anyway, that's everything for the USD CAD. Let's now move to the next pair. Let's now move to the USD JPY. Of course, for the USD JPY, nothing changed at all. The signal has just been triggered and now it's going in the right direction. All I can tell you is we can actually expect a pressure on the market on the USD JPY, and it might make another pullback, and we can start by the USD JPY exactly from the same level I have mentioned to start buying. So nothing changed for the USD JPY. The signal remains the same. Let's now move to the UST CHF. Okay, I'm very happy. The UST CHF has indeed reversed and went all the way to the take profit level and marked the exact reversal from the exact level where I have mentioned to start shorting the pair. Anyway, let's now check the UST CHF and let's check what we can do next with this pair. Most likely, we're actually going to start shorting the UST CHF. Let me just tell you something right here, my friends. We're having a support trend line which recently has been breaking out from, and this was indeed a false breakout movement. The real level of the resistance trend line lies exactly right there. And if I draw here a channel just like that, we can see clearly that this was the real level of the channel of the support. This was the real level of the support, the real level of a support, real level of a support. Meanwhile, this was simply a false breakout, which means we can actually expect from the UST CHF to rise again for about 17 pips, retesting the broken support trend line or the channel, and after that it's gonna continue the fall. Of course, that is all analyzed on the 1 hour time frame. I need to go to the daily chart just to confirm if the market indeed gonna continue the fall. And as we can see, my friends, the pattern right here confirms that the UST CHF is gonna continue the fall. That strong bearish breakout candle is actually confirmation for the momentum. It's actually confirming that the momentum is gonna continue and the bearish movement is gonna resume. Let me just tell you something. When you are seeing a bearish breakout candle, just like that looks like that actually, this is the bearish breakout candle with a small wick at the top and longer tail at the bottom. Usually, that indicates a continuation in the momentum, which means we can expect from the USDC, what is this? We can expect from the USDCHF to continue the fall right away. That's the reason I'm giving you this signal with a very tight distance of about like 16 or 17 pips only, which means we will have to wait for, let's go back to the daily chart, sorry, to the 1 hour time frame, and let's again draw the channel just to be sure of our entry, exactly just like that. So now we need to look at the left side to confirm if there was indeed a strong resistance level. And as we can see, I think right here exactly. Yes. This was, my friends, the real level of the resistance. This was the resistance number one. This was the first attempt of the resistance, and we can simply start shorting the USDCHF right on the second attempt of the resistance, which is also going to be the retest of the broken channel or the supported trend line. And if we check on the left side, we can see clearly that this was a strong resistance level. However, the safe zone should be ranging just till the peak of the resistance, exactly right here, exactly at 0.97473, which means the safe zone is ranging for about 41 pips. Meanwhile, the take profit level has to be placed exactly right here at the peak of the nearest resistance to our entry, which is going to be at 0.96153, which means we are aiming approximately 92 pips profit from this signal. Let me now write it for you. And there goes our signal, my friends, for the USCCHF. Hopefully it's going to be a good one, and hopefully we will make good profits out of it. Let's now move to the next one. And let's just move to the gold, which is also going to be remaining the same, because the gold right now is almost approaching the entry level, which I have sent last week right here. Where is the take profit level? It should be written here. 1 second. Take profit level at 1729.03. That's going to be our take profit level. I believe the gold is eventually going to continue the fall till it reaches the lowest level of the support. I mean, I don't really need to repeat the same analysis from the last week or the last Saturday. The analysis just remains the same. And again, the gold, same like the USDJPY, just remained the same and nothing changed about it. So I believe that's everything for the midweek analysis. I hope you guys will enjoy making these profits with the signals. And again, please don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and of course, turn on the notification bell button. And don't forget, my friends, to give a chance to our premium group. I believe it's going to be a very good week, and hopefully we will make a lot of profits to our clients. So in the end, I hope that was informative to you, and I would like to thank you for watching.